Hey guys, what's up? It is Ripe again, back with more revenge stories. If you haven't already, please don't forget to check out my Patreon at patreon.com/ripeyoutube for exclusive Reddit content. Without any further ado, let's dive right into the stories. And the first one is titled, A Young Disabled Parent? Yeah, right. When I was a kid, my mom had some joint issues, arthritis, stuff like that, badly enough that she needed a wheelie walker to get around when she was out and used a walking stick at home. Surprisingly, she is much better now. They never quite figured out what caused it, but she does not use either a stick or a walker now. But I digress, the point is she had a walker and a permit to use a disability parking spot, but she looked young and fit. I think you can see where this is going. This was several years ago when I was less than 11 years old, so it won't be verbatim, but it gets the gist of the tale. We are getting back into our car in the very full car park after shopping at a particular warehouse. Hint, famous for sausage sizzles, and an elderly lady comes storming towards us, husband in tow. And guys, if you know what kind of warehouse the person in the story is talking about, then please let me know. The cast is entitled Lady EL, Husband H, Mom M, Me, Me. My mother is in the process of putting her walker into the car. She is literally maneuvering what is clearly a folded walking frame into the boot. Entitled Lady,
Excuse me, why are you parked in a disabled spot? Just because there's no other places doesn't mean you can steal a spot from an old man who needs it.
Mother, struggling with walker, I have a permit. Entitled Lady,
You're far too young to need to park this close. My husband needs this park much more than you.
Husband, leaning on walking stick,
It's alright dear, she does have a permit.
Entitled Lady,
I don't care if she does, she doesn't need it.
Turning to my mother,
You should be ashamed of yourself.
My mom does not say anything and stands there kind of dumbfounded clutching the walking frame. The husband manages to convince his wife to leave it and they go into the store and a bunch of people are giving my mom dirty looks. I wish I had been older at the time, I would have told that lady very clearly and loudly for the benefit of the bystanders giving my mom dirty looks that my mother did need the park, as not only did she have a wheelie walker and a shopping trolley, but also three children to get into the car. Whereas you, lady, had a husband who was quite happy to walk an extra 20 meters and let someone else use the park. Not a very satisfying ending, but at least the man was nice and actually used his eyes. Just wish people would not prejudge because someone does not look physically disabled at first glance. I gotta say guys, recently what I have noticed is that it is getting more and more common, at least in my country, that people park in disabled parking spots. So I can definitely see why someone could confuse someone for not actually being disabled, but then again, the person in the story, aka the mother, does have a wheelie walker and a shopping trolley, so it should be obvious that she might be disabled. Have you ever noticed someone that is obviously not disabled and still had the audacity to park in a handicapped parking spot? Let us know in the comments. And the next one is titled, Handicapped Parking is for Handicapped People, Not Rich Ones. First, just for your information, in most handicapped parking spots there is a place next to the parking spot marked off for loading and unloading wheelchairs. In the US it is usually painted with diagonal stripes. Onto the story. My son and I were at Walmart and as I parked I saw that a new BMW convertible owner decided that that striped spot was set aside for him. I looked and there was no sign of a placard or handicap tag. This pissed me off and I stewed about it the whole time we were shopping. When he was still parked there when I came out, I decided to get spiteful. I found a piece of paper and left a note on his windshield and it said, "So sorry, I did not mean to scrape your car with my wheelchair. I would leave my contact info, but you were illegally parked blocking my van. So good luck buffing that out." We sat in the car another 20 minutes and waited. Out came this guy that looked like a personal trainer. He came jogging up to his car, chatting on his phone. He saw the note, screamed, "Oh crap!" Then he spent the next 20 minutes going over his car, inch by inch, rubbing every speck of dust or dirt. He was still looking when we left. Nothing harmed, no damage, just a lesson hopefully learned. And guys, if you have watched until here, please don't forget to like the video and also post some star emojis in the comments if you want to support me. And in case you are new around here, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel to join our awesome community. Thank you very much for your support. And the next one is titled Make My Life Hell at Multiple Jobs? I Will Get You Fired. Backstory: in the early 2000s I worked for overpriced CD store. I really like my job aside from one coworker, let's name her Karen. We just didn't get along, I made the best of it, but she was a borderline bully. Of course, she gets promoted to keyholder and proceeds to turn into a full-blown power trip bully. She made my life hell and a job that I previously loved I could not stand anymore. I made a formal complaint that made its way to HR, but I was done working there, which was her goal. Of course, when HR investigated my claims, they found she and the assistant manager were dating. Oops. And she was moved to another store since fraternizing was against policy. Apparently, she did not like that store and quit. A few months later, I was happily working at defunct bookstore, and who gets a job at the defunct bookstore at another mall? Karen. Over the next few months, she proceeds to do little things to annoy me, like hanging up when I would call their store for a customer or leave me on hold forever. Of course, I would get in trouble for
not effectively handling the customer with their needs.
The revenge: about 6 months into the job, I heard through the grapevine of store gossip that Karen had been injured in a car accident. Apparently, she had hurt her back and went on medical leave. She could not stand for more than 10 minutes at a time without excruciating pain. This is important. She was on indefinite leave and her store could not hire anyone to replace her while on medical leave, leaving them short-handed, and I knew her manager was really annoyed after a few months. 2 months later, a few friends of mine and I decided to go play pool. A former coworker, Rick, from the overpriced CD store was there. Rick: man, too bad you went out here last night. It would have been a reunion. Karen and assistant manager were here playing pool. Me: Karen was playing pool? Rick: oh yeah, they come in every Wednesday night. Me: really? That's interesting. Every Wednesday, huh? How long has this been going on? Rick: a few months now. Yes, for the entire time she was on medical leave, Karen was out playing pool once a week, not at home in debilitating pain like she claimed. The next day, I went to her defunct bookstore and asked to speak to the manager. I told him all about her weekly pool sessions and encouraged him to be at the pool hall the next Wednesday night to catch her in action. That Thursday, she was fired. The last time I saw her, she and her friend were attempting to follow me home from work. I called the police and led them into the police station, where they told her to leave me alone or be arrested. She stayed away from me after that. And by the way guys, how is that in the US? If you are sick, do you have to get a certificate or something from the doctor and then give it to your employer? That is the way we have to do it in Germany, and obviously while you are sick, you are still getting paid for that day. I am wondering if it is a similar procedure in the US. Let me know in the comments. And the next one is titled I am a disabled veteran. Longtime lurker, first time poster, I am on mobile, bear with me friends. Yesterday at work, I was the only cashier for 6 hours. It was kinda busy for a Tuesday, but I am used to it. While I am ringing someone out, a lady yells from the line that someone is causing trouble in the back of the store. I asked her what was going on and she replied, "A man back there is being very disruptive. He's yelling and cussing at this kid and pushing him into shelving." I had never been met with this situation before and was not sure what to do, so I called my manager on the radio and had the woman explain to him what was going on. As my manager goes back, the woman and a few other customers in line start to talk about this guy going completely overboard and shoving his 5-year-old child. Finally, the line starts to dwindle down and the next customers I have seem to be talking about the situation too, so I asked what was going on since I was stuck up front and had not seen it. Yeah, that was a huge mistake. This was the family. The guy that was accused of berating and punishing his son harshly was face to face with me. He starts going off.
"Apparently, I cannot even discipline my own child."
Name of our store.
"Think they know the law. You guys don't know the effing law. It's my kid."
So I tell him that I was not even aware of what was going on, but he keeps yelling at me.
Your manager said he was gonna call the cops. Well, where the F are they?
I shrugged and again said, I'm not even aware of the entire situation. His wife tells him to calm down and forget about it, and then he grumbles some more and they leave. I am thinking, cool, it is all over and done with. But nope, a few hours later I went to talk to my manager about changing my availability, and he says he just got off the phone with our district manager. Apparently, the guy called customer service and complained, saying things like,
the manager cussed me out and told me it was none of my business. He doesn't know the law. He told me he studied law in Florida. I am a disabled veteran and I demand respect. If I don't get an apology from your store by tomorrow at 5 PM, I will be suing.
My manager. Not the store, he wants to sue my manager specifically. I want him fired, blah blah blah. My manager is actually really cool, so he's just laughing the entire time, reading us the guy's statement, where he includes his full name and a bunch of other information. My manager even went to his Facebook page and showed us all these pictures of him doing a variety of things and said, he does not look disabled to me. Anyway, it is 2019 and basically every store has cameras, so my manager said he will have our loss prevention guy go through the footage and send it to the police. Since none of the customers who actually saw it wanted to stick around, I had to write a report based on what I saw. And the next one is titled, Don't Fire People Who Don't Work For You. I had taken over running a small development team of 9 for a relatively big company. We were there for basic, quick little bits of software that wouldn't make sense to outsource. Web apps that quiz employees on policy, fancy interactive projects to show off at conferences, or just an extra pretty PowerPoint. The guy I took over from ran the team like we lived in the 1980s, so I brought us into the modern age, and surprise surprise, within a few weeks our team was finishing projects left and right and center. I won't go into it here, but if any tech nerds are interested on how bad it was, I will reply to any comments. Everything was going great, my coworkers could take smoke breaks and listen to music, our internal clients were kept up to date with their projects, and my boss thought I was some kind of software prodigy as productivity had gone through the roof. Honestly, this was more indicative of how bad it was before rather than anything I did. Then comes Dick, short for Richard of course. Now you know Dick, you probably have a Dick at your office. They've been there too long to fire and delight in slapping people in the face with their seniority, regardless of whether or not they have anything to do with you. First, he sends us a project and marks it critical, as in,
everyone stop what you're doing now, this needs to be done yesterday.
I politely sent him a message and asked him if I can move it down to medium priority, as there was little to no time limit and we had other projects to deal with. He replies,
no, it needs to be done now, get to it.
I'd like to remind everyone that he's not my boss and has no authority over me or my team. So I CC my boss and the other department heads who we had projects for at the time. Hi all, hope you're enjoying your day. Dick has asked me to work on this project for his department, however, he wants it to be done now, which would delay your projects. Would that be okay with everyone? Turns out that is a no, and I downgrade his project. Now Dick starts to live up to his namesake. A week or two later I check our Trello, task management software, and notice Shia, fantastic programmer, great person, was falling a bit behind. I go to ask her what is up, and she looks like she's about to have a panic attack. I ask her what's wrong, and it turns out that Dick had threatened to fire her if she did not start working on his project immediately. I calm her down, let her take a break, tell her to start working on her regular projects, and to send Dick to me if he gets uppity. I then fire off an email to Dick and my boss, reminding him that, first, any threats of termination need to go through me and HR first. Who works on what projects and when is determined by our schedule and myself. Third, if a project's deadline is moved up, I should be informed directly, not via my team. It turns out that Dick is infamous for making threats like this, but because nobody took them seriously, I was the first to remind him he had no authority over other departments. I did not find out until later, but apparently he had a meltdown at the boss about how incredibly disrespectful I was. He tried to file a formal complaint, but it was rejected because doing my job properly is not actually a problem. Who knew? At this time I accepted a better job and was going to put in my notice, but I wanted to wait until after our latest project, let's call it the Ninja Report, was done, as it was a big deal for my team. The Ninja Report was part of a presentation by a company Big Wig, boss's boss's boss, and was marked critical, so all of us were working hard to make sure we did a good job and got it on time. Now finally, we get to the revenge. I am plugging in a switch under the desk when someone taps me hard on the shoulder. Just a minute, mate. I stand up and stare directly into the red face of Dick, erect with fury and ready to expel his rage all over the office.
I'm not your mate, you need to learn your place in this company.
As this grown man is screaming at me in full view of my team, it certainly dawns on me that I get severance, have another job lined up, and really have no reason to deal with this.
I want my project done now.
He continues to yell. Now, I could have just told him about the Ninja Report, I could have said a lot of things, but I just smiled, looked him in the eyes and said, as long as I am working here, the schedule is not changing. Predictably, Dick responds,
then you're fired.
So I grab my things and leave. As I am leaving, one of my team comes up looking like a deer in the headlights and asks what they should do. Easy. First, I want everyone except you to stop working on the Ninja Report. Second, at the end of the day, send an email to the boss and the bigwig, let them know what happened and explain that Ninja Report is going to be a week late. See you all for drinks on Friday. I wake up blurry-eyed the next day to a call. Me, hello? Boss,
hey, look, I'm sorry about what Dick said. He doesn't actually have the authority to fire you and the Ninja Report cannot be late. We need to fix this.
Me, oh, I'm sorry, I've actually accepted another job. But don't worry, I figured this would happen. I asked one of my team to work on it privately. If they start working on the Ninja Report again, they should be able to get it done on time. My boss tries to get me to come back, but I made it clear that was not going to happen. Recommended one of my team take my job and thank him for the opportunity. He's pretty cool about it, confirms I will be getting severance and tells me he can use me as a reference. Friday drinks roll around and we have a lot to celebrate. The Ninja Report was done on time and given everything that happened, it made my team look great. I got a new job, teammate got a promotion, and Bigwig was really eager to learn why his subordinate fired the lead of the team he picked himself and nearly tanked the project. I am proud to report that the office is now 100% Dick-free. And guys, what is that famous phrase? Never mess with a man who has nothing to lose, because a man who has nothing to lose is most dangerous, or something like that. And in this case, this phrase absolutely reigns true. Have you ever gotten revenge on a coworker? Let us know in the comments. And the next one is titled, Future Sister-in-Law Thinks My Disability Is Not Important Enough to Accommodate at Her Wedding. My brother is getting married in July, I have a service dog for my various disabilities, and since the day I found out about the wedding, she has been unwilling to accommodate my need for my service dog. She has made various excuses like,
what if the dog gets hair on my dress? We don't want dogs eating food off the table. What if he jumps up and messes up my dress? It is expensive and I don't have the money to replace it.
I have made it clear that I cannot be at the wedding without my service dog. Both my mom and I have also made it clear that he would never do any of the things she has mentioned. And now suddenly it is the venue.
Well, we don't know if the venue will accommodate you.
I mentioned that they had to legally and my brother was like,
still.
Seems like they are trying to find any reason to deny me. We are re-evaluating the topic in July, and if it does not go well, I might just show up with my service dog anyway. Could really use some support from you guys. And a user in the comments said, ask your brother and soon-to-be sister-in-law point blank, do you want me to go to your wedding? Be honest, because without my service dog I cannot be there, so what do you want me to do? Their reaction will speak volumes. I also have a service dog, she's a guide dog, and my family would pull this allergy crap every Christmas. I would get a call on Christmas Eve and my sister-in-law would be having a flare-up but be fine the following morning. She is genuinely allergic, but it is mildly itching, not EpiPen levels. After 2 years of this, I stopped going. I now have an invite me, expect my dog rule for everything, and I am the only one who chooses when she does not come with me. I would reevaluate your family at this point, honestly. I would also definitely ask them out and then shame them publicly. And another person said, that makes no sense. I am extremely allergic to dogs, like hives and swelling allergic, but your service dog is not a pet. How dare they expect you to leave the dog home? OP, I agree that asking point blank if they want you there is a good idea. Also ask if she understands the difference between emotional support and service animals. Obviously, her concerns are not warranted with a trained service animal. Jumping, dress smearing, food, facility accommodations, service dogs simply don't behave like that. They would flunk out of service dog school. Make sure your brother understands you won't go if your service dog is not welcome. That would be like telling someone in a wheelchair that the chair must stay home. And guys, I'm wondering if any of my ripe stars actually use a support animal. Let us know in the comments, and also let us know whether you have ever been in a similar situation where people did not allow you to take your service dog with you. And guys, unfortunately, we have already reached the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed today's stories, and if you haven't already, please also go to patreon.com/ripeyoutube, where I upload exclusive Reddit videos starting at just $3 a month. This is a great way to support me in case you are interested, and the chance for me to become independent from YouTube revenue. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe and like the video, and I hope to see you again tomorrow.